Halo, this is the Mega Construx Halo Maverick series of micro action figures that come in the blind bags. This is the full series, so let's go through them from common to ultra rare. Thankfully, this updated Halo Wars Marine is one of the common figures in this series, and that's good because it means that people will be able to get this a little bit more easily and perhaps in larger numbers if desired, because I think this will be one of the more desirable characters or figures from this series. That head mold looks really good, especially viewed from straight on. Looks like it comes straight off the CG, one of the art, you know, displays showing just the model just by itself looks just like this, especially viewed from the front. So nice shaping for the armor pieces, a nice variety of different colors. You know, it's not all just a two-tone thing overall. A little bit off with the application of the skin tone on one side here. You know, just a little bit, but that's really not so visible if you're anything farther than a foot away from it. Overall, I think a pretty good looking figure and a good start. Here's another common figure. This is just kind of a generic version of the NMPD trooper, or one of them. With face mask, it's basically just showing you another police tactical unit that is not from New Mombasa. This one, haven't seen the official name for the character yet. As of the time of the recording of this video, Mega hasn't put it up on their site, but you see what it is, and it just represents a police unit from some territory other than New Mombasa, I believe. This one you could call a Recon Spartan, or you could just call it Agent Carolina if you want. It's entirely up to you. This really shows, I think this color really shows up the shaping of the armor here, especially the chest and the shoulder armor pieces. I don't know, just something about it, the way that it deals with light around the corners that just shows the molds really well. Yeah, shows the quality, the overall workmanship that went into the design. The visor on this one is a little bit off. You know, they got just a little bit of kind of overprinting with the gold of the visor, but at least, of course, it does have the all-important black around the outline. If they didn't have that on there, that would be a darn shame. But yeah, just needs a little bit of touch-up, but I think this is a good one to have in the collection. The Athlon Spartan is another common one, and this one has, I don't know, it almost looks like it's intended to be all one color of blue, but there are some parts where I can see little bits of speckling, like especially this shoulder armor piece on this side. You know, it's just a little bit speckled up, and I see a little bit of it, I guess, in the other armor pieces, but it's more subtle than usual. You know, normally you have a lot more contrast in there, so that's interesting. It's different. Just a little bit of metallic sheen to this one, ever so slight. But yeah, a slightly different treatment overall. Of course, the needler over here, the visor on this one is okay. It looks good on this side, just a little bit thin on this side, but that actually feels like it gives it a little bit of depth. I don't think it was intentional, but overall the figure looks fine. The final common figure from this series is this Elite Commander with a not exactly navy blue. It's more like a sea blue, ocean blue. It has a little bit of green in it, a little bit more than navy typically does. It's a cool color. It's different, and it's subtle compared to the Under Armour color, which appears to be just ever so slightly brownish of gray. The light skin tone, of course, and he's got the plasma rifle over here, which feels a little bit softer than they have previously. I mean, this really squishes easily. I feel like they've changed the plastic on that. Maybe they have experienced too many breakages and bendages of the appendages back here, unintentional, which I have seen on some. You know, and also the squishing of the center section there. With a softer material, it just becomes more difficult to make that actually damaged, you know. This way it can always just be pulled back apart. I kind of don't like the feeling of it being so soft, but if it reduces occurrences of damage and malformed ones, then I think it's a decent compromise. The color is still fine though. Maybe it's just a little bit on the matte side, but I actually like that. This ODST is a rare figure in this line, so a little bit less common. And out of the ones that I got to put this series together, this one has the worst small errors in the painting, the printing, because the blue spills over to the top and to the bottom of where it's supposed to be. That's unfortunate. It's also just a little bit of fuzziness around the black on the visor, and it kind of misses a spot there as well. I don't know. I feel like for this series, they just turned up the speed on the production line like 5 to 10% or something, just beyond where it needs to be to get good consistency. I hope they'll turn that back down just that slight amount. It's really tough to find that sweet spot, but I feel like they've gone just a little bit fast of it, and I hope they turn it back down just a little bit to tighten up some of those prints and paint applications a bit. All right, more of the classic style of grunt here. So this one has the new head mold for it and the new armor pod, whatever that is, carapace mold as well. The paint applications on this one are not bad. I'm not sure if that shell was supposed to come together a little bit tighter than that. It doesn't seem to be bent. I think that may be intentional. The paint application on this one, or the color overall, the main color for this one, I should say, is really nice. It's got just that right amount of iridescence to it. It's just very appropriate for the type of material that the Covenant used. So I'm happy to see that here. Did not look so good used on the Oni Reap X vehicles, but on something like this, it's ideal. So this guy is right now set up as a suicide grunt, but doesn't come with a weapon, but of course take one of those grenades out of his hands and he can be whatever you want him to be. Has the same articulation as the grunts, the super articulated grunts they've done up to this point. Head's able to turn all around. It's able to go up and down just ever so slightly. I guess maybe a decent amount. Decent amount. And, you've got the two-axis joint in the shoulder, and this comes up and down. You've got the ability to rotate the wrists around. Little feet are able to rotate around, and he's also on ball joints in the hips, so he can look like he's kind of waddling along. Last up is the Haribo Gummy Rogue Spartan in a nice medium blue with just a slight bit of green in it. So it's slightly cyan, not a true blue. This is a beautiful color. Really just looks so crystalline, looks so icy. I like it. I like the depth that this shows. The head looks proud the way that it's set up. I guess you could also see this as being an earlier version of Carolina, right? And we got the nice plasma rifle there, which interestingly in this material actually feels slightly less soft, but with the clearer resin, but still a little bit softer than they were before, but it's all good. Yeah. I think I'm good with the whole idea of bringing these gummies back into just the regular circulation rather than having them as the secret rares, because everybody was just going out and going through whole boxes of those as soon as they were put on the shelves, find the secret rares and then just put them on eBay. So they really weren't able to get into the hands of many normal fans, especially younger ones. So I'm happy to see these out there and a little bit more accessible. Of course, that's all very relative. You still have to live in a place that is so lucky as to actually get any new products from Mega within months and months of their release. I got these off eBay because I'm not going to wait for months and months and months, but yeah, that is what it is. Distribution sucks from Mega right now, especially when it comes to getting new stuff out there on the market. Except for the Pokemon stuff. That actually came out pretty quickly and pretty widely. But that's it for my look at Maverick series. My favorite figures from this series personally are the Grunt, the Marine, and the Recon Armored Spartan. I like the Gummy Spartan as well, but the Recon just stands out a little bit better to me. Thank you for watching. I'm going to keep working on more videos, so I'll be talking to you again very soon.